reality. You're my sunshine, you're my best times, you're my anomaly. And I'd choose you in 100 lifetimes. I'd choose you in 100 worlds. I'd find you and I'd say I do for the rest of my life. With all and I will, when the sky is falling, I promise you I'm all in, no turning back. And every day, every moment, every breath you take, I choose you. This is more than just a wedding. This is etched into eternity. With our union, he'd choose us in 100 lifetimes. He'd choose us in 100 worlds. He'd find us and we'd sit. Come on.
Trinity, have I pronounced it well? Yes, it's your day, so I want to see you smiling all day, okay? It's your day, so I want to see you smiling. Officiation ceremony doesn't take long. 30 minutes, we're done. So it's not a long process, 30 minutes, 40 minutes, we're done. I want us to pray before I begin everything. Let's bow down our heads and pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, just want to bless you, honor you, and glorify you because you're here with us. Thank you, because you knew this day will come, and it is here, oh God, when Owen and Trinity will be joined together in holy matrimony. Father, we invite you to be the witness and the great witness in this ceremony, oh God, because they have come here, not to me, not to Pastor Walala, not to anyone, but to you and you alone, God Almighty. Father, Holy Spirit and Son, let you be in this place and take charge and take control as we start this ceremony. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Lord God said, it is not good for the man to be alone. Actually, maybe for 2 minutes, let me request you to take your seat. Thank you so very much, because you can get tired. The Lord God said, it is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him. 19. Now the Lord God had formed out of the ground all the wild animals and all the birds in the sky. I will jump that one, but I'll get to verse number 21. So the Lord God caused the man to fall into a deep sleep. And while he was sleeping, he took one of the man's ribs and then closed up the flesh, the place with flesh. Then the Lord God made a woman from the rib he had taken out of the man, and he brought her to the man. Now the man said, this is now bone of my bones. I'll replace the man with Owen. Okay? Now Owen says, this is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, for she was taken out of man. In this case, Owen. That is why a man leaves his father and mother and he is united to his wife, and they become one flesh. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for the reading of your word. Speak to us in this moment. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I just want to explain something in less than 5 minutes, and then we'll proceed. God caused man, he had created in the Garden of Eden, to go into a deep sleep. When he slept, he took one rib, and out of that rib, he formed another man. He made a man he had created. Anabanga muntu pachiyambi mulungu. Muntu yo munda mwa Edeni, nkumpangitara gone tulo. Ndiyali ntulo mkudenga kujani, ntiti, imene mkupangira so muntu. So, he made a man to sleep, and then he took a rib out of that man and formed another man. Pastor, what are you saying? God made man out of man. But now he made sure that he differentiated these two. He made sure that there was a distinction between these two. And then one man he called male. And another man he called female. So we have a male man and female man. I usually confuse people when I say this. They get confused. As we go along in the next 2-3 minutes, you understand. Sorry, Owen, we'll just speak to you a little bit, just for the sake of understanding. One can sit in the anybody. Montu. Wamuna. Wamuna. Muntu. One kazi. So there is male muntu and female muntu. Correct?
Mm.
That means there is male man and female man. The head of the family. Now, when I say head, I'm not saying dictator. Hello? When I say a husband is the head of the family, I'm not saying he is a dictator. No. When you are the head of an organization, that means you are responsible for the organization to perform. When you are the head of the household, you are responsible for the operations of the family. If the family goes haywire, it is the responsibility of the man. If the family is a God-fearing family, that means the man is responsible enough to teach the wife. Are you following me?
Yes.
So head does not mean boss. Head means responsibility. Are you following us, Bambo? As my mripo, No, head does not mean you are the boss. Head means you are responsible. Amen. And when the Bible says husband should love their wife, it simply means you have to love your wife. No questions asked. Because it is a command, not a request. Amen. Azibambo, Bible whether you like it or not, because the Bible doesn't say ngati mukufuna mukozo wako ndakazano. No. Are you with me, church? When the Bible says love your wife, doesn't request, it is commanding. Same way, when the Bible says wives submit or respect your husband, it's not a request, it's a command. So whether you like it or not, you respect and you submit to your husband. Amen. Amen. When we say submission, doesn't mean you are a remote controlled. No. You wear a little whooping and you, hey, Bambo. Hello, you wear, so we don't challenge, hey, Bambo.
Hello,
to flat the minute, deeper one or two, yeah, hey, Bambo. No, it's not like that. When we say submit, it doesn't mean you have to say, hey, Bambo, anytime. No. What we need is respect, which comes from the heart. When we say respect, what do we mean? The Bible clearly says, husbands, love your wife. And when we say love, there are many, many things which need explanation. When you say love your wife, there are many, many things that are included in this loving business. Okay? There is provision of everything in the house. There is providing the moment. And you are the good thing to own. Okay? Just like I was saying, please practice this. And you know what? The Bible doesn't stop there. The Bible says, he who finds a wife finds a good thing. And he finds favor from the Lord. Which means when you do that, all will be favored by God. In the process, all of you are favored as a family. Are you following me? Owen, you have found a good thing. And God says you have found favor before the Lord. Please look after your wife. Take care of her. She is your star. She is your diamond. She is your everything. Amen. Can you please stand? Dearly beloved, having said these few words, though I have taken several minutes, we have come together in the presence of God to witness and bless the joining together of these two people in holy matrimony. The bond and covenant of marriage, as I said, was established by God in the Garden of Eden during creation. And Jesus said, it is so. And he proved it by attending the wedding in Cana in Galilee. This union of husband and wife in heart, in body, and in mind is intended by God for one. Women is into our forgers into that is mutual joy. For the help and comfort given one another in prosperity and in adversity. And three, for the procreation of children, if it is God's will. Am I clear there?
Yeah.
Therefore, marriage is not be entered into unadvisedly and lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes to which it was instituted by God. For because if we join you two people, yet there is a reason behind, it is not, you know, worth it before God. God does not regard it as marriage. But if there is nothing, we may proceed. Anything? We're good to go, people. Thank you so much. May I invite witnesses and causeways? Please come forward. A witness for the groom and witness just for the groom this side, and for the bride you may be this side. When we are joining these two people, we are not only joining these two, but we are joining two families together. And I know wherever you were taking care of Trinity, Just like you were taking care of Owen all this while. You were giving him all the support, just like you were giving her all the support. That support, they need it even now and the days to come. Because when they are within the network of the families, there is safety and there is progress. Amen. Please give them that support. And when they are being joined together like this, you as the witness for Owen, don't say, Trinity, you've come to steal our son. No. But the attitude you should have is, Owen, you have brought us a daughter which we don't have, we didn't have before. You understand, right? And just like your family and you as well, when Trinity is getting married, don't say, Owen, you have stolen our daughter. But say, Trinity, our daughter, you have brought us a son whom we didn't have before. So in that case, that brings two families together, and you are always working together as one. Amen. So I will ask you questions and you answer individually. I'll start with a witness for the groom. When I ask you, you should say, I do, they will say, but you say we do. Why we do? Because you are representing the whole family, just like you represent the whole family. So when I ask you, please say we do. Let me know your name first.
My name is Mo Blessing Sekete.
Sekete. So I'll just call you Mr. Kondowe. Mr. Kondowe, I'll ask you the same questions and please answer we do. Or if you don't, please we don't. Okay. I hope Trinidad is not sweating now. Mr. Kondowe, do you accept as a family that Trinidad should be joined together with this man in holy matrimony?
100%.
Do you promise to love and encourage Owen as you would your own son?
Don't have any problem.
Do you accept that the children born into this family will be theirs and theirs alone?
Exactly.
In the case of death of the woman, do you accept that the children will still belong to the man?
Exactly.
Amen. Let's put our hands together for that. Thank you so much. Let me just come to Owen and Trinity. As I will be asking Owen and Trinity, let me just relieve you. You may now go and sit down. Thank you very much. Let's put our hands together for the witnesses. In the name of God,
in the name of God,
I, Owen,
take you, Trinity,
to be my lovely wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
With God as my witness.
With God as my witness.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Congratulations. I will now ask the bride, in this case Trinity. You repeat after me. In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I, Trinity. Take you, Owen. To be my lovely wedded husband.
To be my lovely wedded husband.
To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Until death do us part. With God as my witness. This is my solemn vow. Congratulations. These are the vows which we make after we unveil the woman and we have made sure that she is the man. Now these vows show the deep love that these two people share. But when they are going out there, we cannot know that they exchange these vows. How do we know that? We will know because they will have a ring on their hands. If there are any rings, please bring them forward. Any rings? You can bring the other rings. Thank you so very much, ladies. God bless you. Let's bow down our heads and pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I give you praise, honor, and glory. I pray for these rings, and Lord, as these two people are about to exchange them, I pray that you bless them and bless them abundantly. Let these rings represent the love that these two people have and they share, the unfailing love that they shall have the rest of their days on this earth. May you be glorified because of this process, in Jesus' name, amen. Let me ask the one assisting Owen. Now Owen. It's okay, then we can ask. Yeah, you can just come, please. Yeah, it's okay.
Okay, thank you. I am well.
Okay, please.
Boy, my pick.
I guess.
Oh, the rings are here?
Yes.
Okay.
Can you take the ring which Owen should put on the finger of Trinity? I think the small one. Before we do a certain ceremony, just now I want to ask you, and you should say, I do. Okay? I want to ask you, I do, before you hold hands. Owen, will you have this woman to be your lovely wedded wife?
I do.
To live together in the covenant of marriage?
I do.
Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health?
Yes, I do.
Will you forsake all others and be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
Yes, I do.
Thank you so very much. Trinity, will you have this man to be your lawfully wedded husband?
Yes, I do.
To live together in the covenant of marriage?
I do.
Will you love him, comfort him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health?
I do.
Will you forsake all others and be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Thank you so very much. Now, because... because they have promised like this, I want Owen to be sure that she's the one.
Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah.
So may you unveil your bride, please, Owen.
Just slowly.
Thank you so very much. Is she the one, or we should wait for another one?
She's the one.
She's the one. Congratulations. Yes, please. And yes, please. Be like you're putting the finger, the ring in the finger, but don't. Just wait there. Just wait there. Yes, and then you repeat after me, as the pictures have been taken. You repeat after me. I, Owen,
give you
Trinity,
this ring
as a symbol of my vow.
I honor you
with all that I am,
and all that I have.
In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may put now the ring on the finger. Can we please give Trinity the... Yes, please. Yeah, just hold it, and then you give it to Trinity.
Yes, you can give it to... Yes.
And then you raise your left hand. Yes, like that. Now you repeat after me, Trinity. I, Trinity, give you Owen this ring as a symbol of my vow.
I honor you
with all that I am.
With all what I have.
And all that I have.
And all what I have.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
May I put the ring. Can you please show them? Show them, please. What you do, and Trinity husband and wife. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Yay.
And let me say this. The Bible says, let those whom God has joined together, no man put asunder. Nene nchijewa. Amene mulungu walu mbigizita ba mozi. Basabizika mungosa oda ndiwini wali ganeze. Angoswe, magolo, angolo, kazi anti, ajimwene, asisi. Don't separate these two. God has put them together. Let me add, sometimes people...
Yours, I give my love to you. We are two becoming one. Here I am, here's all of me. You have all that once was mine. Yours to hold, I'll stay.
Yes, please. Thank you so very much. Agula Agulu, Gambi Abanoko, Baka Tsikulo Selan Tutun, and Baba Zena Jon Tusa Siyane.
Genda Gati Kunda.
So Owen, from now till sunset, you'll be like this. She's your wife and Trinidad. He is your husband. So I've just given you an example. You're taking pictures, so please do. Otherwise, I didn't get to face this part. Honor and glory. Thank you because of this moment, oh Lord. You have witnessed the joining together of this man and of this woman. They are now a family. They are now husband and wife. But I pray that as they start this phase of life in their life, oh God, you begin with them. Walk with them. Provide for them. Be their guide. Be their teacher. Be their leader. Teach them in everything, oh God. Because everything, oh God, should begin with you. May you be the foundation of this marriage from henceforth in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray that you be the protection they shall require on the road going towards their destiny. I pray, Lord, that you shall open doors, O God, in their life. Doors of prosperity, doors of good health, doors of good relationship. Doors, O Lord, of unity and love that never fades, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, I pray that as you so will, may you provide them, O God, the gift of children, and that they shall have that grace to raise those children, O God, according to your word. Father, I pray that when they go through hard times, they should look up to you. When they go through good times, they should praise and worship you, because you are the first in their life. May they, O God, fear you more. May she respect the husband. And may he love the wife. In the name of Jesus, I give you praise, glory, and honor. Amen.
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 Oh, Saina.
Okay.
As long as you still.
still see the look of the one who really loves me. The one who wouldn't put anything else in the world above me. I can still see your love for me.
Heart does go on.